Hello everyone, thanks for stopping by. Lanfone Fall and Winter release is finally here, and I'm super excited to share this shutter card with you today. This new die is so easy to use, and I had a lot of fun using it. I usually start with the coloring, but just this once I started with the card base. I used the main die set as well as the add-on to cut my elements. I have the card base panel, two shutters, and one centerpiece. And what I like to do when I get a new interactive die set is to make a sample to get familiar with it and see how it works. By the way, you can notice that you can create a sleeve to keep the card closed. Well, I decided to skip that part and to create a whole scene on the outside of the card using the biggest rectangle from the large stitch 4-bar rectangle die set. That die fits perfectly the size of the shutter card when it's closed, and I also cut three wavy borders and a tree. And like always, you will find all the supplies listed below the video. So I started with the outside panel that I mostly covered using tumble glass distress ink. I added a little bit of faded jeans distress ink at the top. And next I added some texture to my panel. Water drops first. And then splatters of faded jeans and cheap sapphire distress inks mix with water. To color the borders, I use the peel paint and forest moss distress inks. The tree was cut out of wood grain cardstock, and I used Vintage Photo and Grand Espresso distress inks to color it. Once all my elements were done, I assembled everything on my panel, starting with the borders using double-sided tape, and then the tree using liquid glue. Next, I colored my card base panel. I wanted it to match the front panel, so I used the same blue inks, tumble glass, faded jeans, and cheap sapphire to create the sky on that panel. Like I said, I wanted all the elements to coordinate, so I colored the centerpiece and the two shutters as well using the same inks again. So here are my elements. Next, I needed to create a matching ground, but with all the folding, I didn't want to add another layer of paper. So I used the hillside stencil to create grass borders, just like the front panel, but without the extra paper. I first applied peel paint distressing to create a nice layer, and next I added forest moss to bring more contrast to those hills. And I did the same thing a little bit lower to make a second hill. And of course, I used the same technique to create more hills on the centerpiece. Next, I assembled the shutter card and I started by folding the sides in. I used my bone folder to get a nice crease, and I also folded the small tabs in. I took the shutters and folded the tabs as well. I applied double-sided tape on those tabs, and also at the back of the card base tabs. Now here you can notice that the die has created marks on the paper. Those marks are guides to help you place the shutters at the right spots. So I took the left shutter, removed the backing paper, placed it right up against the left panel between the marks, and I folded that left panel to stick the shutter to it. And I did the same thing with the right shutter. Removed the backing paper, placed it between the marks right up against the right panel, and folded that panel to attach the shutter to it. Next, I removed the backing paper of the top tab on the card base panel. I lined up the centerpiece with the bottom tab, and I pressed down at the top to stick the centerpiece to the tab. I removed the backing paper of the bottom tab and attached the bottom of the centerpiece to finally complete my shutter card. Next, I moved on to the coloring. On the left, the images for the inside of the card, and on the right, the ones for the front panel. I used most of the images from Let's Go Nuts, but like always, I brought more images from older sets to help me build a cute little scene. And like always again, all the supplies are listed below the video. So I stamped the images using jet black ink, used the coordinating dice to cut them all, and colored everything using my alcohol markers. When all my cute images were colored, I assembled them on the front panel and inside the card as well, using glue dots mostly, but also liquid glue at some places. Thank you. To stamp my sentiment easily, I placed the shutter panel in my Misty tool and used jet black ink to stamp "You're the pick of the patch." Next step was to stick the front panel, but before doing it, I attached a piece of twine on the right flap using glue dots. And I definitely couldn't leave that part of the card white, so I stuck a piece of pattern paper from the new Into the Woods Remix paper pack. This paper allowed me to hide the glue dots and simply decorate the card. I trimmed off the excess of paper and attach the front panel on the left flap using double-sided tape. And to match the other side of the panel and hide that white part, I used the same twine and pattern paper. And finally, the card was ready to be closed. So that's it, this is the final result, my shutter card is done. A lovely scene with the cutest squirrels having fun in the pumpkin patch. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye!